Namaste, ladies and gentlemen. Continuing our discussion on the profit leadership, in this particular session, I would like to talk about the project selection. So we spoke about the idea of continuous improvement, which started long time back, when human beings felt that there is an opportunity to improve everything. So essentially, these concepts have started from the automobile engineering companies. Particularly, this idea of continuous improvement is coming from the Japanese culture. That means life can be improved significantly. Anything in life can be improved significantly, provided you are able to see the disconnect and also have a dissatisfaction on the status quo. So if you are thoroughly dissatisfied with the current situation, then obviously there is no question of continuous improvement coming into the picture. So various quality gurus have been talking about this idea of continuous improvement right from the time Shewhart brought this idea of statistical analysis, or subsequently the idea of problem solving came, and then later on Dr. Edward Deming brought this idea of PDCA and so on and so forth. So let us quickly try to figure out what is the origin of this continuous improvement, and then where this idea of project selection is coming from. So essentially, when James Juran brought this idea that the quality triology, which I spoke about it in some other session, which is essentially the quality planning, quality control and quality improvement as the three triologies, the three parts of the whole science of continuous improvement. So Juran brought this idea of project by project approach as what he has called in his continuous improvement philosophy, brought as the Juran's triology. So what do you mean by a project? There are various ideas about the word project, which essentially means constructing a bridge or a metro or rail or something of that kind. But in the context of continuous improvement or any other kind of an application, project is nothing but it has got a definite start, middle and end. That means it cannot go on forever. That means it is completed after some time. So he brought this idea that continuous improvement can be taken up as a project by project approach. That means you can identify an area which is dissatisfactory for the current performance, and then you can try to define a problem and then try to go about finding the root cause and fix it, so that there will be a continuous improvement happening in the performance of the organization. So that is what essentially the idea of a project. That means you need to make everyone in the organization to get involved in this whole game of continuous improvement. This philosophy came from the Toyota production system. One aspect of project selection and then working on the project is essentially, it assumes that there is a problem to solve. There are several philosophies and I won't go through in detail in this session. Essentially, one philosophy is that the whole life is, and this universe has got a lot of problems to solve, and then human beings are there to fix it. So the other aspect is looking into the various strengths we have, and let us build on our strengths and so on and so forth, which is a appreciative inquiry, which I will talk about it later. So nevertheless, a project is nothing but a dissatisfactory performance area where we are not happy with the output, and then we want to take it up and systematically work on it and then solve the problem. So that is what a project is all about. So in an organization, the problem with the people generally is that nobody is sensitive to the problems. Everybody feels that they are doing a great job and everything is going well in their company. There is nothing to solve in their organization. This idea is there purely because many people are not measuring the performance. They don't know what is the real performance of their organization, and they have no comparison with the benchmark, the best in class in the world somebody has achieved. So in the absence of measurement, in the absence of comparison with the benchmark, problem can never be defined. So problem can be defined only when you are dissatisfied with the current performance. If you are very much satisfied with the status quo, and there is no problem for you. So essentially the problem sensitivity of the organizations have come up a long way, that people realized that the competitors are performing much better than them. So having said that, for defining the problem, it is extremely important that we should have a system of performance measurements. I will talk about the performance measurement on some other video, but let us limit ourselves to the context of project by project approach. So having chosen a project, then we have to get a team of people engaged who have got the domain knowledge and they have got a knowledge of tools and techniques in order to know how to fix the problem. So having said that, the organizations can have many little problems which are tiny in nature, which are essentially the shop floor related issues and so on and so forth. So the concept of bottom-up approach came into existence, meaning that let us start solving some very, you know, trivial problems maybe, but may not be giving a big breakthrough improvements for the organization. But the culture of problem solving and the culture of continuous improvement will set in the organization, so that large number of people will get involved and they will come together and discuss about the problems and so on and so forth. So that is called a bottom-up approach. It has got its own advantage as well as disadvantage, which we'll talk about it later. The other aspect is the tackling the tactical level problems, which are little bit strategic in nature, but they are essentially cross-functional issues that multiple departments are coming together in solving the problem and so on and so forth. That is called a middle-up approach of problem solving. And the most important one is what is called top-down problems, which are essentially strategic in nature, which is seen by the high-level people in the boardroom, and they formulate the high-level strategies, and then based on the strategic themes and objectives, the various problems are chosen in the organization. So the bottom-up and middle-up, although has got a lot of benefits in terms of involving the people, etc., but it lacks direction in the sense that where the company wants to go and what are its major disadvantages it has got and what is going to be strategic direction, and hence what are the processes to needs to be fixed and so on and so forth. So it's extremely important to understand that a combination of bottom up and middle up as well as the top down kind of approach is necessary for any organization to substantially improve its performance. So that is what is called the project selection. And then when we select a project, we need to keep in mind few factors which are essential. One is whether it is really going to bring in some financial gains for the company. Is it going to improve our sales or it is going to bring down our cost is a very critical aspect of the factor to be considered. So they are called the screening factors for the project selection. Once we know that it has got a financial gain, the second is how big this project is in terms of the scope that we are trying to fix it. If it is going to be a very large problem, it may be taking a lot of time, which they generally call in the Six Sigma parlance, it is a world hunger project. That means you can keep on attempting it, but you will not find the end of the road at any point in time. So that means the project scoping is very important, that we take a problem which can be solved in about 4 months time and we see the significant financial gains or the customer satisfaction and so on. So the criteria for selecting a project, one is the financial gain, the other one is how big the problem is. And the third aspect is whether it is really going to bring in the cultural change in the organization. People are coming together and then they are trying to have employee involvement, etc. So these are some of the factors which are considered in selecting the problem. So it's extremely important in the context of problem solving. The beliefs are that continuous improvement is coming from solving problems, and solving a problem essentially has to become a project, and the project can be selected from the bottom up, middle up or top down, and then various criteria can be used for screening the problems that we have chosen to solve and select them based on certain priority criteria. So this is a very systematic approach of developing an organization. There is no one single technique that's available for project selection. There are several techniques are available which we'll discuss in the subsequent videos. So I'm sure that this would have given you some perspective on what is a project and how to select a project and so on. Look forward to see you in many more such sessions in the future. Thank you very much for your valuable time being spent with me on these topics. God bless you. Take care.